This apple tastes like an apple. However, it cannot birth another apple. I still feel human, knowing that my grandchild will not birth another child.
My name is Jason Page, and I volunteer at the Multicultural Arts and Activist Center in Chicago. I bring you a special message. We have a rare and distinguished guest speaker at our space this weekend. His name, Thomas Tovey Blott. He is of four people still alive today who successfully escaped extermination camp Sobibor and survived the Nazi occupation of Poland. I believe Tovey's story is not only important to historians, but an important to anybody proactive in the preservation of life and liberty in the world today.
My name is Thomas Tovey Blott. I was a prisoner on the Nazi death camp in Poland called Sobibor. A lot of people know about concentration camps, but besides concentration camps, were specialized in death camps. The only function was to kill people. Sobibor was a death camp. October 14, 1943, the prisoners of Sobibor revolted. We killed the Nazis and we escaped. Our life after we escaped, we were in the forest hiding. Some Germans, the German police or SS apprehended groups of prisoners in the forest. Some were killed by people to rob them. It was very difficult to survive, but about 22 people from Sobibor survived. I'm one of them, and I tell the story just to warn the world to what terrible consequences hate or racism could lead to. My story is not only a history picture, it's also a warning to other people to be careful and be against any form of hate or racism. Thank you.
Yo, yeah. I don't mind stealing bread from the mouths of decadence, but I can't feed off the powerless. Yo, remember this? Okay, check it out. Hunger Strike 2012. Eddie Vedder, what's up? Professor D here, peace, but not without justice, just as before. Breaking news broadcast or more on the one-sided war of a terrorist state against Palestine's perilous fate. And Kadar Adnan's courageous fight ending 66 days of his hunger strike. Abducted in December, community member used as a human shield by troops to enter his home in a violent raid, terrorizing his mother and daughters afraid that they might not see him again. It's the eighth time in 6 years he's been abducted for no crime, interrogated, tortured, but no word or syllable.
Closing this clinic is going to leave a lot of people who are most vulnerable, the mental health community, out here in the streets where a lot of crime and violence is arising, especially noting that the summer is on the way.
One of the things we wanted to do was have a presence out here to say that the people out here are not giving up.
No complaint, they have no victim, they have no witness. We have permission to be here from the owners. Obviously they're confused about what they're trying to do, but they had told us we have to leave. We're not going to leave.
Citizens to judge the law itself as being immoral or unethical, and if we deem so, to vote not guilty and to acquit people from unjust laws.
I'm out here on our campaign to inform people about jury nullification to let people know of their right to actually vote not guilty if a law is unjust or if it's being applied in an unjust manner.
Many people don't know that the jury cannot be tried for their verdict. And a verdict of not guilty is as good as gold. And with the standard of double jeopardy, a defendant cannot be charged twice for the same offense. So even if the law may say that a person's guilty, as soon as the jury votes not guilty, that person is permanently free.
Greetings. In this segment, we'll see Dr. Laura Chamberlain on the what, how, and concerns about fracking. Then, we'll hear from Elizabeth Petula from Southern Illinoisans Against Fracturing Our Environment, SAFE, on the effect on families and the environment.
Hi, I'm Dr. Laura Chamberlain, and I am a member of the Coalition for a Moratorium on Fracking.
So this
here
fracking
in Illinois
can contaminate water, rivers, lakes, aquifers, wells. It can contaminate farmland. It can kill livestock and wildlife, and it can sicken residents.
And there's one other thing that fracking can cause, and you need to know about this, and that is earthquakes. So this is a map of Illinois. Here is where they're looking to frack right here. This is the New Madrid fault line right here, and this is the Wabash fault line right there. And the New Madrid fault line is the most unstable fault line in the country. We do not want to frack right here when we have that fault line right there. Trust me. So what we're hoping that everybody does is go to GaslandTheMovie.com and watch the movie. There's a 45-minute version on that website, absolutely for free. And then you can go to DontFractureIllinois.org and find out more about what's happening here in Illinois. That's DontFractureIllinois.org. And then when you're convinced that this is not good for Illinois, please call your state rep and state senator and ask them to pass SB 3280, with the moratorium on fracking and an investigative task force. And the number for your state rep and state senator, 217-782-2000. And then when you're done with that call, will you please call the governor? And his number is 312-814-2121. And thank you very much for those calls. We can beat back the frack attack in Illinois. Thank you.
Her friend was supposed to come over, right? But dude, I'm gonna tell you what,
In the past, a frontal lobotomy was a cure for being crazy. Today, we have aspartame. It's less invasive, trust me.
We all know the veteran has played a tremendous role in shaping and moving and participating in social movements in this country, from the American Revolution to the Iraq-Afghani wars. So on that note, I want to go ahead and sort of introduce how we're going to conduct the evening. We're going to do a panel. We have folks from, oh, here's another convener, Bill Bianchi. You thought you were going to get away. Bill Bianchi is another convener of the NRC, so he just...
Fine with everybody? Can everybody hear me clearly?
Yes.
Good. Thank you, Sheila, for that humble introduction. And really, the struggle that I come from is a continuous struggle that has been ignored or put brushed away because of just the consistency of struggles that we get hit with on a daily basis on a different level.
Yum. Hi, fructose corn syrup never tasted so good. I just want to hop around and not focus on anything right now.
Possible to have an Ashwami Taco in Chicago that would be free of any kind of contribution to the solutions of the
Yeah, I mean, you have some kind of a farm in your backyard or something, a way to grow your own vegetables.
Almost in everything that we do, as we learned in the biology class, harms the planet in one way or another. Agriculture is one of the biggest culprits in what's turning Earth into an uninhabitable for many life forms. So if we wanted to wake up and just have an earth-friendly taco, a taco that would not contaminate the planet, a taco that was not transported by trucks or by planes in any part of it, could we actually have a taco?
I enjoy fluoride in my water and in my toothpaste because I don't want to have control over my free will. Life is just easier that way.
The Jewish problem, the question was not to kill the Jews or not. This was already settled. As a matter of fact, at that time, in the eastern parts of Poland, they killed already any Jew who was in the village or the city. But how to do it more efficiently? The execution of Jews in the eastern territories in Poland and in Russia supposed to be very difficult for the soldiers and, most important, very slow. The discussion on the Wannsee Conference was how to speed up, how to do it more efficient, and how to deal with the Jews in Europe, actually. The first time they talk about not only the Polish Jews, but also the European, Dutch, and other states. As a result of this conference, in very fast succession, three death camps were built under a code name Operation Reinhardt. They built Belzec, Treblinka, and the most secret one, Sobibor.
Welcome to the Heart of Chicago, location of Q4 Community Radio. In this lesson, we will learn basic procedures in Sound Broadcaster and record live shows using Audio Recorder for Mac. Deck A and B is used to transition between tracks and audio inputs. You can find your various inputs and add them to the queue by clicking this plus button. One input is our mixer. This is your transcoding window that sends the signal to the internet. Pay attention to these levels, they are what's going out. In the queue, click plus and choose Mac Line In. Under Record Sound Device, choose Firefly Analog In. Under Display, choose text you want to appear to listeners, such as your program title. In this example, we will use Training for Q4 Radio. Click OK. Now your program is in the queue. Now let's set up the recorder on the Mac by switching to the display from SAM to Mac. Load Audio Recorder. Adjust levels. Click record when ready to go live. Put your headphones on, adjust the phone's audio, mute audio for Sound Broadcaster to prevent feedback, unmute and adjust volume for your microphone. Double click your program in the queue to start. Now for a special transmission.
Strato.